Hello viewers, I welcome you all for today's talk on Heisenberg uncertainty principle in quantum mechanics. The German physicist Werner Heisenberg proposed this principle in the year 1927 and received the Nobel Prize for this principle in physics in 1932 and for his contribution in nuclear and atomic physics. The outlines of talk would be statement of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, various expressions for uncertainty principle, and the nature of light required for the accurate measurement of position and momentum, and some simple problems to enhance the understanding of this concept. The objective of today's talk is to facilitate you all to learn about Heisenberg uncertainty principle. The learning outcomes would be that learners would be able to explain Heisenberg uncertainty principle and express various expressions for uncertainty principle. They will be able to state the nature of light required for the accurate measurement of position and momentum of the particle, and learners will be able to solve some problems. Let me tell the background under which this uncertainty principle was stated. In the world of very small particles, one cannot measure any property of the particle without interacting with it in some way. There is always some uncertainty whenever a measurement is made. It is because of wave-particle duality and the resulting interaction between the target particle and the detecting instrument. This introduces an unavoidable uncertainty into the result. So it is concluded that one can never measure all the properties exactly. The Heisenberg uncertainty principle states that it is impossible to measure both the position and momentum of a particle simultaneously and so precisely. The order of magnitude of the uncertainties in the knowledge of two variables, for example position and momentum, must be at least equal to Planck's constant or greater than or equal to h/2π or h/4π. For position and momentum, we write the product of uncertainties as delta x delta p greater than or equal to h/4π, where delta x is the uncertainty in position and delta p is the uncertainty in momentum. This limitation is critical only for very small particles such as electrons, but not for ordinary sized objects such as cars and airplanes. So Heisenberg uncertainty principle can be clearly defined in the following way. It is impossible to know both the position and momentum of the fundamental particles simultaneously to any desired degree of accuracy. For a particle moving in three dimensions, we can write the expression for uncertainty principle as delta x delta px greater than or equal to h/2π, delta y delta py. So delta py is the component of the momentum along y-axis, and the uncertainty in its measurement is delta py. So delta y delta py is greater than or equal to h/2π, and delta z and delta pz greater than or equal to h/2π. In general, this principle states that it is impossible to specify precisely and simultaneously the values of both members of particular pairs of physical variables that describe the behavior of an atomic system. The key words in this definition is precisely and simultaneously. Okay, in physics we have some pair of variables like position and momentum, energy and time, angular momentum and angle. For a pair, energy and time, we can write the uncertainty principle as delta E dot delta T greater than or equal to H by 2 pi and delta J dot delta theta as greater than or equal to H by 2 pi, where delta E and delta T are the uncertainties in determining the energy and time, and delta J and delta theta are the uncertainties in measuring the angular momentum and the angle. So one more way we can define the uncertainty principle is the order of magnitude of uncertainties in the knowledge of two variables must be at least Planck's constant h. So delta x dot delta p is approximately equal to h, delta e dot delta t is approximately equal to h, delta j and delta theta is approximately equal to h. Here h is the Planck's constant and its value is given by h equal to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. So the product of uncertainties is approximately equal to Planck's constant. It can also be written as the product of uncertainties could be greater than or equal to h by 2 pi. So a constant divided by 2 pi, or the product of uncertainties must be greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Once again, this becomes a constant. So you can see the product of uncertainties is nearly equal to Planck's constant, or Planck's constant by 2 pi, or Planck's constant by 4 pi. Now, some important points we will discuss about this uncertainty principle. This principle applies to all particles, whether free or bound. For example, an electron can be freed from the atom by applying some energy called ionization energy. So the electron has become a free electron. Or you can consider an electron inside the atom also. So the electron now is bound to the atom. Yet you can apply this principle for the free particle as well as the particle which is bound to a system. Next one, position x and momentum p of a particle can be measured with limited precision only. You can measure simultaneously, but the precision will be limited. The reason for this is the wave particle duality in nature, that is, the particle has particle view and wave view, and these two can never be incorporated simultaneously in the same experimental findings. And the next important point is that Planck's constant h appearing in the uncertainty principle has got a very important significance. When h becomes zero, the quantum mechanical results change to classical mechanical results. Because if this h becomes zero, then the quantum concepts becomes just the classical concepts. The uncertainty principle does not restrict the possibility of simultaneous measurement. Of course, it puts a limit on the amount of simultaneous accuracy in the two measurements. So uncertainty principle never tells that two physical parameters cannot be measured simultaneously. It just says that if you measure simultaneously, the accuracy involved will be limited. That's all the concept of this uncertainty principle. This principle is of great help in understanding many phenomena in atomic world. Thus, uncertainty principle is fundamental intrinsic property. Now let us study about the implications of this uncertainty principle. It is impossible to know both the position and momentum exactly. That means delta x, the uncertainty in the position of the particle. If there is no uncertainty, delta x has become zero. And there is no uncertainty, delta p equal to zero. It is impossible to get such result. So when you measure position and momentum simultaneously, one will be accurate and the other will be less accurate. These uncertainties are inherent in the physical world and have nothing to do with the skill of the observer. Because it is so small, these uncertainties are not observable in normal everyday situations. This uncertain principle is applicable for micro world, for all the particles. You are not able to detect the uncertainties in daily life because the product of uncertainties is at least equal to Planck's constant. H is very, very small. Its value is something 10 power minus 34 joules second, very small. So when the constant is very small, you are not able to realize in everyday situations. Now let us see some facts about Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Consider a free particle. Suppose when you measure the position and momentum of this free particle, we can say that if momentum is completely specified very accurately, then you can guaranteedly say its position is completely unspecified. That means when you measure two physical parameters simultaneously, one is completely specified and the other becomes completely unspecified. We can write the statement this way. If it is completely specified, suppose momentum P is completely specified, it is very accurate, then the uncertainty in measuring the momentum should be taken it as zero. Suppose you are taking first observation, measuring the momentum of the particle. Once again, you find the momentum for the same particle. Both the times, if you get the same reading, then the change in the measurement of momentum, so delta P becomes zero. And when position is completely unspecified, when it is completely unspecified, the uncertainty should be taken as infinity. Remember this concept. If you know this concept, easily you can solve many problems. If it is completely specified, uncertainty in measuring that property becoming zero. If it is completely unspecified, you should take the uncertainty as infinity. Example 1. The uncertainty of the position of an electron is zero. Then what is the uncertainty of its momentum? So without calculating, you can tell if one uncertainty is zero, other one should be zero or less than or equal to h by 4 pi or greater than or equal to h by 4 pi or infinite. So if you have understood the concept, this clue itself tells uncertainty of the position of an electron is zero means straight away blindly you can say uncertainty in measuring the momentum would be infinite. I hope this example gives you little more understanding. Why we are able to say this? You can see velocity of light c equal to nu lambda. Okay, velocity of light is a constant. So if you say lambda is small, then nu should be very high. If nu is very small, then lambda should be very high. So come back to the problem. Uncertainty of the position of the electron is zero, very small. So naturally, uncertainty in finding the momentum would be very high. What is the highest value? Infinite. Now let us solve it. We know the product of uncertainty is delta x, delta p is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. If delta x is 0, what is delta p? Delta p becomes infinity. So answer D is the correct answer. Next problem. To locate an electron, you need to interact with the particle with the help of light. So to locate an electron, you need to strike the electron with a photon. The electron has such a small mass that striking it with a photon affects its motion in a way that cannot be predicted accurately. Now, light photon has energy and the electron mass is very, very, very small. So when the light photon touches the electron itself, it changes its position. This itself will introduce uncertainties. So you cannot predict the position very accurately. So the very act of measuring the position of the electron changes its momentum, making its momentum uncertain. So let us picturize this situation. A photon is striking the electron. Now, electron is here. Electron, let us assume that it is at rest. When a photon of energy is striking it, so this is before the collision, electron is at rest, photon is coming. Now, after collision, look at the picture. The photon just gets scattered. Initially, it was moving like this. Now, because collision has taken place, photon has collided with the particle. So, after the collision, the photon is moving this direction, means electron which was at rest here starts moving. So very difficult to locate. You want to study where it is located. So while measuring the location, introducing uncertainty in the momentum of the particle. So we need to adopt some technique. To measure the position of the electron, you need to shine light on the electron and detect the reflected light using a microscope. If you want to make the uncertainty in measuring the position of the particle minimum, then you should use proper wavelength of the light. So the particle size should be almost equal to wavelength of the light used. Only then you can measure the location of the particle with less uncertainty. To determine the position accurately, it is necessary to use light with a short wavelength. By Planck's law, we know E equal to H nu, nu equal to C by lambda. When the wavelength is very small, then energy of the photon becomes very high. So a photon with a short wavelength has a large energy. Thus, it would impart a large momentum to the electron. As a result, electron just displaces from its rest state. But to determine its momentum accurately, electron must only be given a small kick or small momentum. This means you need to use light of longer wavelength. You want to measure position. If you use light of shorter wavelength, the particle receives energy from the photon, particle moves. So if you want to measure the momentum, you need to use light of longer wavelength. But our aim is to measure position as well as momentum simultaneously and accurately. So how it is possible? You are going to measure position and momentum simultaneously. So can you switch on a light of shorter wavelength and light of longer wavelength simultaneously? Very difficult. That is why uncertainties are introduced. So use light with shorter wavelength help us to have minimum uncertainty in measuring the position, but not momentum. If you use light with long wavelength, you are able to measure the momentum accurately, but not position. The more accurately the position is known, the less accurately the momentum will be known, and vice versa. The more accurately the energy of a particle is known, the less accurately we know how long the particle possesses this energy. So the energy can be known with perfect precision, means delta E should be taken in as zero, and the measurement in time becomes infinity. If you want to measure the energy of the particle very accurately, so then what you have to do? You need to take the measurement on the amount of energy possessed by the particle for infinite time, which is not possible. That is why we say when you measure two things simultaneously, they become less accurate. You just go through this problem. It will help you to understand the concept well. A pitcher throws a 0.1 kg baseball at 40 meters per second. A small body whose mass is 0.1 kg and that ball is moving with velocity 40 meters per second. The momentum is measured to an accuracy of 1%. Calculate the uncertainty in measuring its position. Let us find the solution. We know the product of uncertainties in measuring position and momentum is given by delta x dot delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Momentum p equal to m into v. So what is the momentum here? You know, mass of the particle 0.1 kg and velocity is 40 meters per second. So you can calculate what is the momentum. Now, uncertainty in momentum. Here the problem states that the accuracy of measuring the momentum is 1%. So what is the uncertainty in momentum means delta p. You have calculated the momentum. So uncertainty in measuring the momentum delta p is given by 0.01. Why 0.01? 1%. So 1 by 100 gives you 0.01. into the momentum. Momentum is m into v. You have substituted the value of m. You have substituted the value of v. So this is the exact momentum. But the problem states that the accuracy of measuring the momentum is 1% only. So what is the uncertainty in measuring the momentum? It is given by delta p. Delta p is 1 by 100 into momentum p. So you substitute 1 by 100 is nothing but 10 power minus 2 and momentum is 4. So you are getting what is uncertainty in momentum. So what is the uncertainty in position? So delta x is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi into delta p. You know the value of h. You substitute the value of pi here and you find out the uncertainty in measuring the position of the particle would be 1.3. into 10 power minus 33 meter. It is very, very, very small that you are not able to measure it. So we cannot observe the effects of uncertainty principle in everyday life. Let us take one more example. An electron travels with a velocity 40 meters per second. The momentum is measured to an accuracy of 1%. Calculate the uncertainty in measuring the position. Here, instead of a macroscopic body, you have taken an electron. Let us see what is the uncertainty in the position. Electron is too small and its mass is known as 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. So, solution, let us find out. You know the product of uncertainties. This formula delta x dot delta p is greater than or equal to h by 2 pi. Mass of the electron we know, velocity we know. So what is momentum you have to find out and what is the uncertainty in momentum you have to find out. And then easily you can find out the uncertainty in position. You now see what is the value you are getting. 1.4 into 10 power minus 4 meters. Whereas for a macroscopic body, it was some value into 10 power minus 34 something. Whereas here, it is 10 power minus 4. Okay, so this is somewhat bigger value. So for very small particles, you can measure the uncertainties easily, but not for a bigger particles. So next problem is a similar problem. An electron is moving along x-axis with the speed it is given. What is the minimum uncertainty with which we can simultaneously measure the uncertainty in locating the position of electron along x-axis? So mass of electron we know. You find the solution now. You know the formula. You find out the momentum. You find out the uncertainty of momentum. It is 0.5%. 0.5% means 0.5 by 100. You calculate what is its value. Then you can find out what is the uncertainty in the position. It becomes 11 nanometer. One more problem. The problem says that in an experiment, an electron is determined to be within 0.1 millimeter of a particular point. If we try to measure the electron's velocity, what will be the minimum uncertainty? Uncertainty in position is 0.1 millimeter. So you have to convert into meters. delta x dot delta p is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Momentum you have to find out. You know mass into velocity is momentum. Mass is given and you are going to find out what is uncertainty in its velocity. So uncertainty in momentum delta p equal to m into delta v. Okay, so delta v is 6.63 into 10 power minus 34 divided by mass you have substituted and you have written the value for delta x which is 0.1 millimeter. Millimeter means 0.1, so you will be writing 10 power minus 3 meters. 1 millimeter is 1 into 10 power minus 3 meters. 0.1 millimeter is 1 into 10 power minus 4 meters. Substitute this, you will be getting this answer. One more interesting problem. The position of both an electron and helium atom is known within 1 nanometer. And if uncertainty in locating, in measuring the momentum of electron is given as 5 into 10 power minus 26 kg meter per second, then what is minimum uncertainty in the measurement of momentum of the helium atom? Let us see now solution. We know this expression delta x delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. For electron, let us write delta xc delta p greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. For helium, you write the same expression. Now, this is h by 4 pi is a constant. So, right hand side, both expressions have h by 4 pi. So, the expressions on left hand side should be the same. Okay. So, delta xc and delta h for helium atom, one and the same, 1 nanometer. So, you have substituted 1 nanometer into what is uncertainty in measuring the momentum of the electron. 5 into 10 power minus 26 equal to, so uncertainty in position of helium atom is 1 into 10 power minus 9. And what is uncertainty in the momentum of helium atom? So delta pH. So 1, 1 goes, you are getting the same expression. So delta P, once again, same 5 into 10 power minus 26 kg meter per second. One more problem is given. Compare the uncertainties in the velocities of an electron and proton confined to 1 nanometer box. Once again, for both particles, uncertainty in position is same. Their masses are given. 9.11 into 10 power minus 19 kg is for electron. 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg is for proton. So you write the expression. You write separately for electron. Write separately for proton. So you are asked to find out what is the uncertainties in velocities. So delta x delta px, for delta px you substitute mass into velocity. Uncertainty is happening in velocity. So take the mass of the particle outside the bracket. So delta x into mass of electron into delta v for electron is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Same way for proton you write. Then you find the ratio of delta V by delta V P. That is, that becomes mass of proton by mass of electron. It becomes 1835. This problem also, instead of doing these many steps straight away from your common general understanding, you can answer this question. Because you know mass of proton is approximately 1835 times mass of electron. One more example is given. Show that the uncertainty in the location of the particle is equal to its de Broglie wavelength lambda, then uncertainty in its velocity is equal to velocity itself. So in the problem we said to locate the position of the particle, wavelength of the light is very important. So here they say uncertainty is equal to de Broglie wavelength. You know the general formula, delta x delta px is approximately equal to h. So you write delta x delta of momentum mv. Now m you take outside, the variable is velocity. So delta x delta v is h by m. Delta x is lambda and lambda de Broglie wavelength, lambda we know it is equal to h by mv. So delta v equal to h by m into delta x, h by m. Delta x is given as lambda, and lambda value is h by mv. So if you substitute, you will get the answer as v, which is velocity of the particle. So I hope all these 8 problems would have enhanced your understanding of the concept of uncertainty principle. I hope you enjoyed today's explanation of uncertainty principle. Thank you, one and all.